Hey friends, Azure Data Factory enables you to do hybrid data movement using a self-hosted integration runtime. But now you can share one self-hosted integration runtime across all your data factories, which improves manageability and it reuses that same highly available and scalable infrastructure. Gaurav Malhotra is here to show us how it works today on Azure Friday. Hey folks, I'm Scott Hanselman. It's another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Gaurav, and we're going to talk a little bit more about Data Factory, but you're going to teach me about something I had no idea about, this idea of the integration runtime.
Yes. So we have this piece of software called self-hosted integration runtime that you can use to do hybrid data movement. Mm-hmm. So if you have data, let's say an on-prem SQL Server, Teradata, Sybase, DB2, you can use this piece of software that comes with Data Factory and needs to be installed on a machine that has direct line of sight to your on-prem environment and Azure and allows you to do hybrid data movement. And what was there before the release that we are not, that we are talking about today is that if you had, like, let's say 10 data factories in your organization, mm-hmm. and all those data factories were doing some sort of hybrid data movement, meaning from on-prem to Azure, then in they need to have one self-hosted integration runtime per data factory.
Now, and you have to maintain that, be conscious of it, keep it updated, make sure it's healthy.
So you can imagine that for an IT admin, it's kind of an overhead because now they need to make sure that it is installed on a machine, the machines are up and running because the actual data movement happens via the machine where this piece of software is installed. Mm-hmm. With this release, we are saying that now you can share the self-hosted integration runtime across data factories. And again, it will be, like you asked the question already, it's quite beneficial for the IT admin from a manageability standpoint. And the infrastructure works according to this. So if I have a visual, so let's say you are in an Azure Active Directory tenant and you are Contoso AD and you have two data factories in your tenant. Now, the Contoso IT data factory has a self-hosted IR that you actually want to share across data factories. So what we have introduced is what we call as a linked self-hosted IR. So in the second data factory, which is the BI project data factory, you would create a linked self-hosted IR, which would refer to the IR that was created in this Contoso IT data factory. And not only that, we have full, the IT admin has full control on who can refer this particular self-hosted integration runtime in other data factories in the tenant. So he manually has to grant access to the other data factories so they can refer to this self-hosted integration runtime. And I'm going to show that with your demo right now.
Please.
So here, what I have is a Contoso IT. This is Azure portal. I have a Contoso IT data factory. You can see over here that I'm in the visual tools that Data Factory provides. I've clicked the connections tab over here and gone to the tab for integration runtime. You can see that I already have a self-hosted integration runtime that we use for hybrid data movement created over here. And if I click edit over here, you will see that now we have a new tab, which is called sharing. And in this sharing tab, you can see that all the data factories with which this self-hosted integration runtime is shared. And now you can grant permission to any other data factory as well. So let's go ahead and search for the data factory that we want to grant access to. In this case, it's called Contoso BI Project 3. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to say, yes, I want that factory to be able to refer to the self-hosted integration runtime. So we have given that access. And now for that factory to use this, they need to use this resource ID that we have there in the sharing tab. So I have the corresponding data factory opened up here. And now if I go in the integration runtime again and click new, and I want to do data movement, so I'll select that. So as I mentioned, you can create a linked self-hosted IR. So I'll click this linked self-hosted IR over here, and I can just say Contoso linked IR. And here I'll paste the resource ID that I just grabbed from the original self-hosted integration runtime, and I will say finish. So once I create this, now you can see the connection has already been created and it was lightning fast. And you can see over here in the edit tab that I have this self-hosted, this integration runtime referring to the original self-hosted integration runtime with all the nodes information and the concurrent jobs that you can run.
These runtimes, it's not a single service on a single machine, right? This is, it can be as large as it needs to be to move as much data as it needs to be, right?
Yeah, so that's a great point.
So it's almost an integration runtime farm.
Yes, so you could create a network of integration runtime up till four nodes, and we distribute the jobs in an active-active topology in a round-robin fashion. So it's not a single point of failure. So if one node in your farm were to go down, the other node would pick up the load.
Interesting.
So now if I go in a particular pipeline over here, I've created a pipeline called Hybrid Data Pipeline. And if I go in this pipeline and I have a, I'm trying to move data from a file share to a blob. So if I click edit and I go to the connection tab and I click edit over here, so instead of using the default integration runtime, I can come here and say that use the linked IR that I have created to do the data movement. So if I do that, I need to provide the password for that. So let's provide the password. I'm going to do a test connection just to make sure that it works.
Do I have to think about scale? Might I push too much through an integration runtime and it would tell me that, hey, slow down? Or how do I know? Because it sounds like a really powerful thing to be able to reuse these, but I wonder also if it could become a problem.
Yes, so we have guidance published on, so as you can imagine that this is a particular server on which you are installing the self-hosted integration runtime. So if you're trying to, let's say, move a terabyte worth of data and that server on which it is installed is just a single core or dual core machine with 2 gigabyte memory, of course the throughput and the performance characteristics that you would get would be very less. So we have guidance published in our documentation on how much data you're trying to move and what kind of skew you should be using to do the data movement.
Okay.
All right.
Do you think that the thing that's most interesting about this, though, is that people can now reuse these nodes and they may have slack or extra capacity?
Yes.
Like, there's no reason to build out a four-node system if you can't reuse it.
Yes. So earlier, the problem that we heard from our customers, and we got a lot of feedback on this, is even though you have one integration runtime per data factory, most of the times our customers are doing nightly loads, right? Which means that server is up and running for the remainder of the day and doing nothing. Now they can use a single self-hosted integration runtime and scatter that load. And that way they don't have to manage multiple machines and they can use the full power of that machine.
Fantastic.
So you can see now the connection is successful over here. I'm going to say update this to use the linked IR. And once this updates, we can go trigger a copy from an on-prem file share to Azure blob using this linked IR. So it's still updating the connection to make sure that everything.
Do these runtimes update themselves, or are they something that, like, is it something that I would update regularly? Do the people who are already using runtimes need to do anything to get this new capability? They just need to upgrade to the latest version?
So we have this auto update capability that you can set up. And once you do this, we automatically update your integration runtime as we release new capabilities or add updates. It's up to you. You can turn it off and manually update it. So total flexibility to our users. So now it has updated. If I go to my pipeline, I can actually first publish these changes because I wanted to use the new linked integration runtime. And once these changes publish, I can just go ahead and click a particular run to show you that now how the data movement can happen using this self-hosted IR.
And it's as fast as I can throw data, as I can throw bandwidth at it. It's as fast as I can throw integration runtime CPU capacity at it?
Yes, exactly right. Because the data movement is actually happening on the node where the self-hosted integration runtime is installed.
Okay.
So now I have triggered a data movement.
Because I've seen you move terabytes around very, very, very quickly.
Yes, and we are actually moving petabytes worth of data every month for a bunch of our customers. So you can see that this is in progress. I already had a run already happened for this. So you can see that in this particular case, there was around about 659 megabyte worth of data that was copied from a file system on-prem to Azure Blob at 23 MB per second.
That's pretty fast.
Yes.
Fantastic. And then, yeah, and then of course the notification just pops up right there.
Yes, so you could, you can look at that. You can essentially create alerts on top of these pipelines, as you can see over here, and get notified on when that completion happens.
Well, it's such a much better use of resources.
Yes.
And this means that people can then run everything through one IR and then repurpose the other machines for other stuff.
So reusability is the key here, and that's the whole point on the feedback that we got from our customers, and we enabled this feature.
Okay. So tell me again how I can get this if I'm already thinking about IR or already doing this.
So we have a blog post that's out that you can use to understand step-by-step on how you can share the self-hosted integration runtime across data factories. And this blog post will provide you information and also link you to the documentation, which is there in our Azure documentation, mm-hmm. where we mention step-by-step on how you can enable this in your data factories.
Fantastic. Thank you very much for sharing.
Thank you.
I am learning all about how to more effectively share the integration runtime and make hybrid data movement possible with the Azure Data Factory today on Azure Friday.